Bobby.
Friends for fans, some emphasis. Raise your hand, the Wonder Man.
trying to afford a pair of trainers. Imagine when it changes. Imagine satisfaction when you make it. It's more than being famous, more than the applause, and more than any form of status. One of the performances in 24 and faces. Benadon, Vegas, many more praises. Amen, hallelujah, tiny, look what's happened to you. Yeah, they love the attitude, brand new and improved. Yeah, and when the fans start grabbing you, show gratitude with a little bragging too. Amen, hallelujah, tiny, look what's happened to you. Who can say they ran all the obstacles I ran? Look, I traded friends for fans, cement from sand. Raise your hands. Wonder Man.
Don't turn the lights up. Shovel ice that stole me, turned to stone. You shine me when I'm alone. Thank you. disco, like real disco, disco, disco.
The It's like putas, they hear me coming through your speakers. You see me mashing up your airways. I know you can't get enough of my sound. It's like putas, they hear me coming through your speakers. You see me blocking up your airways. I know you can't get enough of my sound. There's no place to hurt, so stop the fight, I'm gonna get it. All this running from me, baby, you're gonna regret it. I can understand why you can't free yourself and let it go.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to DreamHack Summer 2012. Good start, Joe. Good start, Joe. It's the League of Legends Grand Final. Let's hear a bit of noise. We've got a big crowd here waiting for this game to go on. If you're lucky enough to follow me on Twitter, @Joe_Miller, by the way, you will have noticed that Moscow 5 were a little bit late here.
Yeah.
They were very close to disqualified from the first game. They were close to forfeiting the first game. They got here, though. However, their punishment is CLG have first ban, first pick in every game in this best of three.
Every single game. They will be starting on the blue side, CLG. So that is a massive advantage straight away for CLG. You know, the admins have to do something. These guys should have been here an hour ago. And they just literally walked in the door, strolled in like, it's like, hi guys, what's happening? I was just like, what?
You're about to be kicked out. That's what's happening.
I was like, hello,
happening.
There's a tournament going on. So let's get into the picks and bans. You can see the bans coming out already for CLG. They've banned out Darius, Yorick, and Shen. Urgot, Nautilus, and Soraka for Moscow 5, and they are knee-deep straight in there. And Kog'Maw is the first pick. Kog'Maw has 100% win ratio in six games he's been played by CLG so far.
Which means CLG are going to win this game. If the stats GG are well correct played for us, we can just stop now and we'll call it a 1-0. Moscow 5 going in there for Nocturne. Nunu, who they've played a lot down in this bottom lane. Going to be a similar setup by the looks of things here. We've got Irelia in there. I'm interested at the Soraka ban, actually. Mm. Obviously, it's because of the flash banana that we saw from Crepo.
They fear that flash banana.
Yep. And that's something they're going to avoid. Alistair in there as well. Will that be a support Alistair? Will that be Snoopy in the jungle on Alistair? That's what we're going to find out with the last two picks.
Well, yesterday when we saw CLG versus Moscow 5, it was Snoopy on Alistair. He went very aggressive. Didn't really work out too well, but we have got Twisted Fate from Alexic already. So this is a very strong bottom lane, a very strong jungler, and a very strong mid. And Moscow 5, you know, they've turned up. They're up against it. It's nothing new for them. You know, they don't really get cheered that often, but people wanted them in this final. But CLG, I think, are going to be the outstanding favourites. We'll find out in a minute, Joe.
Yeah, after yesterday's game, I have no idea how this final is going to go. I'm not going to lie.
No.
It looked like Moscow 5 were going to win that one. Obviously, they had a 400,000 gold lead, I think it was.
The biggest throw in the history of League of Legends, I think we could call
it. It wasn't a throw, it was a comeback.
It was a comeback.
I'm not sure.
No.
You know, as commentators, we have to make it sound exciting rather than the fact that Moscow 5 just threw it away.
Just threw it heavily away.
I don't know. But we are seeing the next picks. My screensaver just came up, and there is the bird.
That's
the
what we
iceberg
wanted. So,
I'm surprised that they left Anivia in. They obviously feel that they can deal with him. I mean, they technically dealt with Froggen's Anivia, but then Froggen dealt them a lot of Anivia.
Well, it was against Karthus, and it was Froggen that started it all because he pinned Karthus in there, didn't he? Alexic got completely pinned, dropped in seconds, had no chance to use that Zhonya's Hourglass. The question is, how can they deal with Twisted Fate? We could see Trundle in the jungle. Trundle, where the hell is Trundle going to go? He's not going to go in the jungle. That's a troll pick. I'm not having that one.
It is a troll pick. It's Trundle.
Ah, see what you did there, Joe? That English humor.
I'm sure someone clapped out there for that, Joe. Thanks, man. Good stuff. I'm not sure whether this Trundle is going to be a real pick or
Vladimir.
Not. Vladimir, a more standard... Well,
That's what we had yesterday. In fact, this is outside of Twisted Fate is the only difference in this team from yesterday, isn't it? Because they did take Nocturne, they did have Ghostly Pepper on Nunu. Corki was the reason why they couldn't get in and take that turret down, and they did have Vladimir. And we weren't saying, why did Vladimir not tank that turret, pull away, take that one hit and get out of there while they just put a couple of hits in? You know, unless we actually get to speak to Alex, because you don't get to speak to the other guys very often. They won't come near the camera. They'll just be like, no.
They don't talk to us.
No, actually, Ghost of Pepper, he chats non-stop online. He's like, he's constantly messaging me. But
he sent me a picture of him as a toddler, which I found quite weird. But
but when it comes to live, they just don't talk to you.
Yeah.
They're shy, bless them.
They're shy, but they're awesome, which is why they're in this grand final here at DreamHack. Let's run down then quickly the teams once again. CLG are going to have that bottom lane of Alistair, Kog'Maw. Last game, Yellow Pete on Kog'Maw in the semi-finals against Fnatic was an absolute monster.
Beast,
I think he ended up 6-1 something. Maybe it was even 8-1 something by the end. My brain's not
And the stats though, he's got 100% win rate on Kog'Maw so far this tournament.
Yeah, and that's a big thing already, a big confidence thing. Wicked on Irelia, don't think we even need to talk about that one. He's probably the most renowned Irelia player in the entire world. Snoopy on Maokai, his favorite jungler. Mm-hmm. So it's always good. Maybe... even if it doesn't 100% fit in your team comp, to be playing on a champion that you feel 100% confident on. And that's something that they got here. And Froggen on Anivia.
Yeah,
well,
what can you say?
That's the same.
Yeah, Froggen is Anivia. Anivia is Froggen. The egg, he's born.
If you killed Froggen,
out of
it would actually turn into an egg, and then you'd have to kill him again.
So, nobody else got that one, Joe. It's all right. Just me on that one.
That's fine.
So, anyway, we're going to go into live in this one. And I'm actually pretty excited for this one because CLG have got all their picks. Moscow 5 kind of got all the ones they wanted. So, pretty much everybody's playing one of their favorite heroes in this tournament. So, it really could be a very open game, very aggressive game. You can see, obviously, that bottom lane of CLG with Alistair in there will be a very aggressive lane in there. Going to try and set things up for Kog'Maw. obviously Gosu Pepe is like one of the most aggressive supports within the game, which is obviously why he actually pulls in a lot of critics, because he can be over-aggressive at sometimes and put himself in dangerous positions. But honestly, this could go either way, Joe. So let's get a bit of a poll from the crowd. It's a pretty big crowd in here. Who wants to see a game? Who wants to see
everyone.
A game? Yeah. So we'll start off. Who wants to see Moscow 5 take this finals? And we're going to be moving into the Dream Arena after this match. So we're going to see, it's not all over yet. There's a best of three. But who wants to see Moscow 5 take this one? Not a bad shout. Okay, who wants to see CLG UEU take this one? Yeah, that's pretty clear.
Oh, Darien's in trouble. He's coming first blood. He's managed to skill the pull in there first. Will flash away. They can't get the dive in, and that was a bit of insane action right from the very start. M5 setting up that line defense. CLG may go in there. He's going to get the stun down. First blood to CLG. He's going to be picked up. The turret won't quite finish him off there. And Crepo will survive. CLG picking it up here. An absolutely insane start to the game. And Moscow 5 don't know what hit them.
Level 1 tower dive from CLG on Moscow 5. What the hell just happened? I do not know. But they all got the assist. Actually, no, Maokai didn't get the assist. That's a little unfortunate for him. He's down there taking the blue out, but it doesn't matter. So they've all been back to buy, so they've all got a big advantage straight away in that lane. You can see attack speed actually on towards Cogmore there. And they've got wards across the board, so they're going to be covering off any Moscow 5 crazy invades that they could come up with, which effectively counters Moscow 5. That is the main thing that stops them.
That is the counter to Moscow 5. If you can be as aggressive as them, or even more aggressive, if that's even possible, I'm not sure that it is. We're going to see a tough game for them here. Let's not forget, though, it is a best of three, and there's still a long, long way to go in this matchup. We saw yesterday what looked like a clear-cut victory turning into a victory for the other team. So let's not count the chickens before they've hatched. Snoopy just picking up the blue buff. You can see Diamond there. Also, on the other side of the jungle, picking up the red. Middle lane, of course, is going to be Frog and Zanivia against Alexic on Twisted Fate. Probably two of the most famous AP players in Europe. Maybe even the two most famous. And Darien could be in trouble again. Snoopy actually coming in. There is the Sanguine Pool. And this time, no dive onto the turret from CLG.
Yeah, he tried to get the knockback straight away there before it's going to Twisted Vance on him. Snoopy has obviously leveled that one up to begin with. Has picked up the blue buff. Looks like he's going to go towards the race. Could go down straight towards Alexic, of course, in the middle. Diamond Proxy is going to pick up this blue buff. Meanwhile, down the bottom, it's going to be start to a stalemate. The middle lane is the one we need to look at, because Snoopy trying to get himself in a position on Alex. Alex has just took a couple of steps forward. That could have put him in a dangerous spot. He's just trying to keep vision on that side, though. And you've got to be careful, because Nocturne's also coming around, so this could be a double gank in the mid. Diamond actually checking out. Meanwhile, in the middle there, Alex has been caught. The Ice Blast comes through. Froggen gets the damage down, but it will not quite be enough there. Meanwhile, Diamond Proc's taking his trip down towards this bottom lane. Cogmore needs to be careful now. Genin and Ghosty Pepper already are starting to engage it. They're trying to bait them in there. Crepo actually being very aggressive on towards Genji, which means they're going to stick to this fight. They're going towards Crepo. The Fear Proc will go off. The slow goes down. Crepo's surely going to be dropped down. He will do. Can they go towards Yellow Pete? They're going to back away from this one. Yellow Pete wants more damage still. And Alex Hitch has to go back to the race. But Joe, this is all square once again. 1-1.
This is exactly what we wanted to see from a grand final here at DreamHack. The two teams which, after yesterday's game, I think everyone wanted to see it all come out like this. And so far, this first match is not letting us down there. Snoopy getting himself double buffed up. As you said, Alexic did have to back away a little bit. He's burnt through his pots rather than going home, so didn't want to miss out on any of that experience and farm in the middle. Gosu Pepper, of course, will be just coming back into lane in a second. And Crepo, who was the victim there to Corki. So far, we have a killer piece on both our AD carries. Berserker Greaves straight away for Cogmore after 4 minutes. That's very, very early. Corki is still in that lane. Obviously, he is ahead almost double in CS, but he's only got the T1 boots right now. So Yellow Pete may be using this early advantage that you had with the first blood to try and push it.
Yeah, and clever play from Wicked as well. We saw Nocturne down that bottom lane. As soon as he was spotted down there, Aurelia went and took down the large golem that the Nocturne is now on. So Wicked went and stole that one away. So taking away the gold from him already, keeping that gold advantage in towards CLG's favor. It is only 200 gold. We are only 4 minutes into this, but 200 gold, 30,000 gold. It makes no difference to CLG. They can come back from anything. They're going to come into this one with massive, massive confidence. They were so confident last night. You can see going Wicked going towards Darien. He's going to have to back away from that one. The Fear Proc will not go off. Wicked will just back away there. You can see Snoopy was waiting in the wings, though. Diamond Prox is going to go back towards that Tri-Bush, walking through that ward. So Snoopy will have spotted him. Snoopy stayed out of sight, though, I believe, there. Darien is going to back off, so he's not going to be able to get anything from that one, Joe. Very, very tense opening.
Yep, Darien gone. Bottom lane is being pushed up here by Moscow 5. Obviously, Genja coming back in after rescuing that 1-1 scoreline with the kill onto Crepo. How are they going to try and force this lane out? The CS there, as we said before, was doubly in favor of Corki, but Yellow Peep back in lane now with those Berserker Greaves on. Got some nice attack speed. Has started to level things back up. Froggen on Anivia did go home, working his way up towards that Catalyst with the mana and health crystal. He'll be back into lane. And we also saw Alex go back for that Doran's Blade. There's more damage again from Wicked. Now, got that assist. Actually only has the boots and pots from his starting items, but he's causing all kinds of problems. Vladimir having a few issues there before he gets level 9. There's a flash which wasn't quite perfectly aimed, but could Genjun be in trouble? Will use Valkyrie to escape out of things. There's Darien again being pressured up at top, and Wicked is looking very confident here, Demon.
Yeah, he's absolutely dominating that top lane. Every time he goes towards Darien, there's a good burst going on. He's trying to life steal only about half of it back. Meanwhile, you can see in the middle there, Alex Hitch now starting to be pressured. Froggen's hit 6. He's going to start pushing that lane a lot more. Alex will keep up the CS, so you can see he's just fell about 10 CS behind. Ignite onto towards Darien here. Could we see Wicked tower diving? It would be a bit of a troll move. You can see Diamond Pro coming in there. He's going to just force him away from that one. Wicked will not go for it. He's just going to back off and buy. He's got a lot of money, I believe, in there. Froggen, meanwhile, just waiting for that blue buff. You can see Crepo actually just leveling up in there. Will he go for the Bullfrost and go to Purple? He's not. You can see it's actually Genja he's aiming towards. Yellow Peak continues, keeps the attack damage going on him. Go to Pepper trying to keep him away. He's got no mana at all now. Has used that Blood Boil onto Corki. Will I continue the attack? You can see Alex Hitch was trying to get in position to go and join that bottom. We've got to keep our eye on Alex. I know Garen, the camera guy, really absolutely hates Twisted Fate because he's so hard to follow on camera. You have no idea where the ulti's going to end up.
Well, we just saw there Snoopy putting his ult, making his presence felt over by this blue buff. Wow. Look at this for an aggressive invade from CLG. Bottom lane's come up, middle lane is there, and you know what? They may even end up diving here.
Well, they did level one, so why not?
Yeah, level one, easy peasy, and they are going to dive in. Gosu Pepper on the tower is going to be made mincemeat here. Where's the kill going to go? Crepo actually seals it. Genja has dove into the tower. He will die with no penalty, really, towards him, or maybe I should put it better, that no advantage from that kill will be given over to CLG. Well, that will leave us at a 2-1, and CLG, they've obviously thought about how they're going to go about taking out Moscow 5, and it seems like the plan is aggression.
Well, CLG said, we are not worried about Moscow 5. This was 2 days ago when they were in the Open tournament. Now they're in the finals. They're still saying, we're not worried about Moscow 5. We know how to beat them. They're one of the few teams that have proven it online. Well, they've proven it. I mean, straight after Kiev, when everyone was just amazed at Moscow 5, they went and won Kings of Europe that weekend later. So they are very strong. They're well aware of how to do it. Moscow 5 setting up, possibly they're going to pick up the blue. Will they follow it through with the dragon? We are only 8 minutes into it. We've not seen too many early crazy dragons, but you never know. We are in the finals, and it's looking like CLG in a position to try and fight for this blue buff as well. Can they get around there? I think Alexis will pick that up just in time. But Moscow 5, need to be careful. Yeah, CLG are going to leash out this dragon. Do they realize there's a four-man Moscow 5 directly above them? They will do now as they come around there. Snoopy taking down very low. He was tanking up the dragon. They're going to have to use the Anivia ulti to try and keep them at a distance here. Yellow Pete still in there. They can try and dive in. The smite came down. I think it was Diamond Pro that got it. Alex Hitch is going to be targeted, though. You can see Alex Hitch go down eventually. Diamond actually uses his ulti, manages to pick up on Snoopy there, but Diamond's actually had to flash out of the back of the pit there. Genja trying to keep some damage down. Oh, Froggen's going to catch him with a stun. Just managed to get the combo on him, but he'd already Valkyried away and just manages to get away from there. Well, meanwhile, Diamond's just farming away on this top lane. Honestly, who picked up that dragon? I thought it was Moscow 5. I'm pretty sure Diamond stole it.
Yeah, it was Moscow 5. The thing that's really worked, I'd say, against him in this one, we saw Yellow Peak getting the kill onto Alex. So that's a real big bonus for them. We've got to have now double Doran's Blade plus the Berserker Greaves with the AD carry. And actually, it looks like Moscow 5 may want to jump in for this one. There's the Pulverize. Gosu Pepper going very low. Did get out of range before that final hit did come in, though. And Crepo doing a good job keeping himself alive. and saving as much damage onto that turret as possible. Gothic Clever gonna go home. So we have Moscow 5 actually slightly in the lead up at this top. We are gonna see Darren with the ignite on him. Wicked going in for the kill. The Q will steal a bit of life back, and that will be just about enough. But Wicked, he's done a great job of bullying this Vladimir constantly in the top lane, keeping him on low HP, okay? Not got the kill onto him directly, but forcing him out of lane and away from that CS could well be enough. Wicked looking to go back. We do have Nocturne in the brush there, ready and waiting for Wicked to step out. And as I say, it looks like Diamond is just going to go home.
Yeah, Diamond's just trying to lifesteal his way and try and bait him out for a little bit of attack, but I don't think he's going to go for it. We're seeing Froggen just picking up the blue buff. Aleksic has just returned to lane as well. He's had to pick up the items. Aleksic actually going Mercury Tread, so obviously worried about that Frostball coming out from Froggen. Doesn't want to get caught out by that one too long. And I mean, he also got the little bit of ability power and hit points with the two Doran's rings. Meanwhile, he got Sheen on Wicked. That's just why he's been doing so much burst damage. Every time he jumps on him, he's getting that Sheen proc going off. Aleksic at the moment, you can see he's farming it up. Froggen is going to come around there, dodges that ice ball once again. He must be so used to having to do that in tournaments. It's like a steady thing. He's like, God damn that bird again. Just dodging it out. But Snoopy actually is just warding out. So they're warding out the river, the jungle area, which does surprise me. They're not so much going for the dragon wards, which obviously is not going to be up for another about 4 minutes' time. We are seeing Snoopy going aggressive here. He could try and come around the back side of Alex. Could easily go for a tower dive. Will he go for it? Snoopy's backing away. Meanwhile, down the bottom here, actually Genjin was trying to get towards Yellow Peak. Ghostly Pepper might have been caught out of position. The Paul Rose can come out, headbutts him back. Surely, no, he didn't go for it. And Ghostly Pepper was allowed to live there, I believe, by Yellow Peak.
Yeah, not quite the damage, not quite the mana either to be really spamming out there, I think, Yellow Pete. As I said before, he'd go back. Double Doran's added to his Berserker Grief since then. Vamp Scepter and Dagger added in as well. For Corkit, we've got the Phage, double Doran's Blade, and still the Tier 1 Boots. Actually, Diamond Prox is going to be waiting here on that bottom outer turret, so we may just see him called into action. Darian's at half HP in this top lane as well, which Irelia may decide to try and force an issue. He does have that revolver now, so we'll be stealing a little bit back in the middle. Alex taking damage as well and having a few problems in terms of the CS there. It's a nice little lead for Froggen. Also got those three assists, which at the end of the day are all going to be valuable. Nocturne did decide to back away, and Darian has lifestealed himself back up to full health in this top lane.
So evening things out. Now, Wicked must be sat on a fair amount of gold. He's been up that top lane for quite a while, keeping up the CS. Yeah, 1,300 gold, so he's only got about enough to possibly going to go for a phase next. Oh, actually, Malkai's going to come around. Ghostly Pepper's going to be the target. Twisted Advance goes through. Ghostly Pepper will go down very quickly there. And you can see Corki just had to escape and go up river. There was no way he could do anything about that. Diamond, meanwhile, has had to deal with Froggen in that middle. And again, he gets that ulti blast combo on him. Doubles up that damage on towards Diamond Pro. Didn't even manage to get it shielded off there. Genja just waiting for his support play. Doesn't want to leave that turret. He's very much pinned in there. And we are seeing, exactly like CLG said, the way to play Moscow 5 is you need to be more aggressive than they are, and they can't handle it. So far, it seems to be working out that way.
Seems to be working brilliantly for them. They are 100 gold ahead, if that even really makes a difference. I mean, it's ticking up level as well. Moscow 5 then taking the lead, so it's super, super close right now. The one thing that I'm a little bit worried for Moscow 5's point of view is this Cogmore down in the bottom lane 2-0-1, obviously Anivia 0-0-3, getting good farm. Top lane Wicked also got the two assists. He's got 95 CS to the 97 of Vladimir. So despite that one death, Vladimir has managed to keep nicely up in terms of that creep score, and has also just come back into lane with the Will of Ancients. Got some cloth armor as well to try and negate a bit of that damage that Wicked's going to be throwing down.
Yeah, cheeky from Alex there, just making sure Froggen didn't go back. But look at the burst on towards Darian there again from Wicked. Has used his ulti as well. You can see Darian's already completed that Will of the Ancients. Meanwhile, Wicked's building towards, well, he actually went back for Mercury Dread, so he didn't go towards that phase, which I just expected him to go for. Instead, Alex has just forced Froggen back. Froggen's just, let's say, forced back. He's got the Rod of Ages now, though, so it's going to be really starting to hurt. 14-minute Rod of Ages is not bad going for the bird. 118 CS, 105, so he has got that 10 CS advantage. Blue buff going to be picked up by Alex Itch here. Meanwhile, the blue buff, I think, has already been picked up by Froggen down in the middle there. Actually, you tell a lie, it hasn't spawned yet, so Snoopy must have been a little bit slower going around towards it. I don't think we saw it get stole, so it's probably just a simple case of it not spawning yet. So Yellow Pete, meanwhile, has actually gone for the attack speed again, so it looks like he's going to build towards a Phantom Dancer again. as we saw him in the last match against Fnatic.
Well, once again, Wicked throwing the Ignite down, knocking Darien to half HP. You're going to have to steal all that luck back. And yeah, that could really help when it comes to this Dragon. Obviously, Vladimir not really being involved on that side of the map. But the fact that Yellow Pete and Krepo are almost up in this middle lane may make it very obvious for Moscow 5. I think Gossip Krepo has just seen that that Dragon is going to be there. Plus, they actually stole the first one away. So they know exactly when it's going to be coming up. And the question is, how are they going to set up now for this Dragon pickup there? CLG starting.